Hi! In this video, we'll cover the techniques and guidelines to take your item to the next level in Zepeto. Let's go over some of the best practices and guideline considerations to follow while 3D modeling. While you're creating your item, it's important to pay attention to its mesh topology. What's topology? The word topology is a broad term describing how parts of something are interrelated or arranged. In 3D modeling, topology refers to how the vertices, edges, and faces of our model are arranged. In the app, we will only see the face components of our model. Thus, we want to present these faces in an arrangement that looks good while the item is static, as well as while the item is moving. What makes for good topology? Faces should have a relatively decent distribution across the mesh. Faces and edges should flow along the model. Avoid making faces pinch by having too many face corners meet at one point. Ideally, good topology on your item will help it move smoothly with the Zepeto avatar. If you need some reference for topology, you can use the template objects from the studio guide as a reference as well as the creator base set's mask. Look at how these objects are shaped by the flow of their face components, and use that as a reference for your own item. It's also important to make sure that the mesh is modeled to bend properly. When a character moves in 3D applications, the vertices in the character's mesh are being pulled along to match an invisible internal skeleton. Thus, the quality of the item's ability to bend around a character is based on how much vertex material the area of bending gets to use. In areas where a character will bend a lot, dense sets of joint loops are used to smooth out the bends. As an example, let's look at the structure of the mask to see these joint loops in action. Around areas that bend a lot, like elbows, knees, or shoulders, we can see that three closely spaced edge loops are used to preserve the volume of those joints while they bend. When modeling an item that covers these areas of the body, similar sets of loops should be made to make these joint areas bend smoothly. Similar to the joint bending problem, skirt items can suffer from jarring-looking stretching when the legs are spread apart. To mitigate this stretching effect, it's important to add some geometry detail to the skirt in the space between the legs. Usually, adding an edge loop or a cut on either side of the middle of the skirt is enough to smooth out the stretching. Solutions vary with each item, so experiment with the density of these central loops to find the right solution for you. It's very important to keep the 3D triangle count of your item in mind while modeling. There are strict triangle count limits that must be followed to be allowed to upload to Zepeto Studio. Check the item's guidelines page for your item type's triangle count restrictions. In Blender, you can check the try count of your item by going to the Viewport Overlays menu and checking Statistics. This option will show the triangle count of all the objects visible in the viewport in an overlay in the upper right corner of the viewport. If other mesh objects, including the 3D mask, are visible in the viewport, they will contribute to the triangle count in the statistics overlay. The triangle count restrictions only apply to your item, so hide other models or isolate your item with the slash key while your item is selected to get an accurate triangle count. In 3D software, face data contains directionality. One side of a face is encoded as outside and the opposite side as inside. In Unity and the Zepeto app, the inside of faces appear invisible, while in Blender, both the inside and outside of faces are visible by default. In Blender, we can turn on face orientation in the overlay's UI settings to get a quick visualization of which way faces are shown. With this overlay, outside faces appear blue, while inside faces appear red. There can be times where a seemingly contiguous mesh has faces that have the wrong orientation. We can fix this through the Normals menu in the Mesh menu while in Edit mode. This menu can be summoned in the 3D viewport with Alt-N. With all the faces selected, we can use the Recalculate Outside function to have Blender try to automatically conform flipped faces to the rest of the mesh. If that fails, we can manually flip selected faces with the Flip function in the Normals menu. In addition to face orientation, faces, edges, and vertices have directionality. This directionality is called a normal. Normals define what direction faces, edges, and vertices point to as outwards. To visualize this directionality, we can toggle some normal vector visualization settings in the Overlays menu. The colored lines that stick out from your model represent the direction of normals on the mesh. 3D software uses normals to show how a mesh is affected by light. Editing normals can change how smooth or sharp edges may appear, as well as the apparent curved or flat appearance of faces. Let's start with edge sharpness. We applied an automatic pass to control edge sharpness in the Modeling Tools overview. Going beyond this automatic angle limit, we can manually assign selected edges as sharp. We can mark edges as sharp by selecting the edges we want to make sharp, going to the Edge menu, and selecting Mark Sharp. The edge will be marked as sharp with a blue highlight. Turning our overlays off lets us temporarily see the edge qualities. Note that edges marked as sharp will only appear so if Normals, Auto Smooth, is turned on in Object Properties. Sharp edges can be useful for emphasizing cloth folds and material borders of your item without adding faces or vertices to the mesh. Mesh normals affect how the mesh is affected by light. We can manually tweak the normals properties by using certain normal editing operations in the Normals menu. Because normals are a representation of what a mesh component describes as outwards, changing this normal information can change how light should affect that component. By changing an object's normals, we can create additional detail in an item where it would be too costly or impractical to do so just by editing the mesh. Normals can be applied to textures as well. The face direction data can be encoded into a texture that allows for additional detail inside of a face. These are called normal maps and can be thought of and applied while working with textures. When creating a top or bottom object, use the top-bottom dummy FBX file. This file can be downloaded from the Studio Guide website. The file contains some base guidelines for what the expected spacing is for miscellaneous top and bottom items to fit together. When modeling a top item, make sure the item doesn't interfere with the red bottom guide, and when modeling a bottom item, make sure the item doesn't interfere with the blue top guide. If your item is a suit, dress, or matched set, then you don't need to check your file off of this guide. If you're modeling shoes, make sure that you check your shoes against the SH Guide FBX file. This file can be downloaded from the Studio Guide website. The file contains a spacing guide for socks to check that your shoes won't intersect with socks. This guide file does not come rigged, so you may need to perform some temporary rigging work to make the guide file work for shoes that require a rig adjustment. Currently, the FBX file that's hosted on the website is incompatible with Blender because Blender cannot import FBX ASCII files. This FBX file needs to be converted to a binary format in order to be read by Blender. While the version on the site doesn't work with Blender currently, we have an alternate file that works. You can find this file in the description below.